Yo, grace and peace. This is Shai Linne from Lamp Mode Recordings, and I'm doing this quick video blog to let you know about a song that I have on my upcoming album. The album is called Lyrical Theology Part 1, and the song is called False Teachers. Now, in the song, I'm making reference to so-called prosperity teaching, and I actually address specific teachers. I wanted to just give you my heart behind it so that you would know that it's not just a case of somebody being reckless or just trying to stir up controversy or anything like that. Before deciding to release the song, I actually sent the lyrics to my pastors and a few others just to get counsel. For those of you who are familiar with my music going way back, you know that this is not anything new, that I've addressed these things before. In fact, back in 2003, Timothy Brindle and I, we had a song on his album, The Great Awakening, called Faulty Doctrine. Now, I've actually never been against naming names. I think there's actually biblical warrant for doing that. At the same time, you don't necessarily want to be hasty about doing that just because it's such a serious thing. And I believe that there are genuine believers who are under these teachers. And so we always thought that it was wise to be careful about naming names just for the sake of not discouraging or confusing the true, genuine believers who may listen to some of these teachers. And so when it came time to do the album, I realized that it had been 10 years since I had last addressed it. And in the last 10 years, the internet has just gotten bigger and bigger. And so we get a lot of correspondence and email from places like Africa. And so that's why in the beginning of the song, I actually shout out my brothers and sisters in places like Zimbabwe, Kenya, Ghana, Nigeria, Malawi. And it's just crazy to me how big this has gotten over there. And so I just said, you know what, let me just go back and just listen to some of the more popular prosperity teachers that you see on stations like TBN. And as much as possible, I tried to have an open mind. I decided to listen to as much stuff that was recent, like in the last year or so. And I just spent a couple days just doing nothing but listening to these teachers back to back to back. And as I listened, I noticed a pattern. It would go something like this. The preacher would maybe make a reference to the Bible, and then they would just go on and on about the good stuff that God wanted to do for people. It usually involved money or healing. And it was always centered on self, as though God exists for us instead of the other way around. But then what they would do is they would often work the crowd up into this emotional kind of frenzy. And oftentimes it would be thousands of people. And even psychologists know that if you get thousands of people into a room and you work them up into this high-pitched emotional state, you can pretty much get them to do whatever you want. And that's exactly what these teachers would do. And so at that point, at the height of this emotional state, the prosperity preacher would start talking about sowing a seed. So if you give this much, then God will multiply it and so forth. Before you know it, people are rushing the stage to throw money at the preacher. It's a straight up scam. And these ministries are pulling in hundreds of millions of dollars, which is why the government in America was investigating a lot of these teachers. And so anyway, in the song, I make reference to three passages: Matthew chapter 7, verse 16, 2 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 to 3, and 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses 9 and 10. And I want to encourage you to study those passages, but I want to read the Matthew 7 passage now. Matthew 7, 15 and 16, it says, this is the Lord Jesus speaking, and he says, "Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are ravenous wolves. You will recognize them by their fruits." So Jesus is telling us to beware, to be cautious, to have an eye out for these false prophets in that they're going to look like sheep. They're going to act like sheep. They're going to pretend to be sheep, but they're not actually sheep. And then he goes on to say, but we'll actually recognize them by their fruit. And when you look throughout the New Testament at what the fruit of false teachers is, it's often accompanied by greed. And so we see this in 2 Peter chapter 2, where starting at verse 1, he says, but false prophets also arose among the people, just as there will be false teachers among you who will secretly bring in destructive heresies. And then in verse 3, he says, in their greed, they will exploit you with false words. Later on in 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 14, he says that they have hearts that are trained in greed. And so this characteristic of greed is something that you're often going to find with false teachers. And this is exactly what we see with those, the popular people that teach the prosperity gospel. And so, like I said, man, I did this song primarily for brothers and sisters who may not have the same access to the resources that we have here in America. And I know that there's only so much that you can do in a song or a video blog, but I just want to encourage you, study your Bible, look at all the passages that deal with false teachers and just notice what they have in common, and then compare it with what you see from prosperity preachers. In addition to studying those passages, I want to recommend a book that dives even more deeply into some of these issues. If you can see it, here's the book. It's called Health, Wealth, and Happiness. Has the prosperity gospel overshadowed the gospel of Christ? And it's written by David Jones and Russell Woodbridge, who are professors at Southeastern Seminary. So that's it. That's all I got for now. Don't be deceived, brothers and sisters. Cling to Jesus, the risen Lord, who laid down his life on the cross, who suffered the wrath of God as a substitute in the place of all who would repent and believe in him. And to all who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ, provided we suffer with him in order that we may be glorified with him. Grace and peace.